Hi from all of us at Happy Tailz. We've put together this video to help you understand the rules of the Peggy Game. We hope you enjoy the game as much as we enjoyed putting it together for you. In this video, we will take you through a step-by-step process on how to play the game. Your game is a board with a circular plate that rotates. You can place treats in the hollows and cover them with the plate as you rotate. Your guides are going to be Bugs and me, Preeti. A few points to remember before we start. Do not start the game when you are in a hurry. Sit down with your game when you and your dog are relaxed. Be excited. Your excitement is contagious and makes the game more fun for you and your dog. At any point, if you feel that it's becoming difficult, stop. Take a break and come back to it after a few hours or the next day. Or you could cut back up a step to when it was easier for your dog to figure it out. Shall we start? Step 1. Identify a quiet spot in your home where you and your pet will not be distracted or disturbed by too many people, noises, and smells. Step 2. Keep a bowl of smallish sized treats handy. Step 3. Place the treats in one of the hollows of the board. Make sure your dog sees you placing it in the hollow. Now, let your dog pick it up from the hollow in the board. Repeat this a few times. Rotate the plate and vary the hollows so your dog learns that the hollows in the board contain treats. Remember that Peggy is a level 3 game. So your dog is using learnings from previous games to figure out how to play Peggy. In previous games, he or she may have used either his paw or his nose to get to the treats. In this game, they need to learn that they can only use their nose to get to the treats. Pawing at the game will only make the lid rotate. It will not open any cover to make the treats visible or accessible. If your dog continues to simply paw at the game rather than use his nose, you will need to change your tactics a bit. You could go back to a previous game like Linus or Sally, which are easier, and work on teaching him or her to use his nose and not his paw. You could also use your finger as a deterrent. When the dog uses his paw, put your finger there to prevent the lid from moving. As soon as he or she puts his nose to the lid, remove your finger and encourage him. In no time, they will start to figure out that the nose is the way to go. Repeat this again and again at an easy level till the dog is completely nose focused. Once you have accomplished this learning, you can move on to the next step.
Yes, good girl. Good girl. Bugs, what a good girl you are.
Step 4. Next, place the treats in a hollow and half close or cover it with the plate. Your dog will attempt to push the plate to get at the treat. Don't forget to praise your dog. Repeat this process with different hollows on the board. Step 5. Now place the treat in the hollow and cover the hollow fully. Let your dog watch you doing these actions. He or she will push the plate to get to the treat. Repeat a few times with different hollows. Step 6. Place the treats in all the hollows and encourage your dog to find them all. Your dog is looking to you for guidance, so your tone of voice and body language makes all the difference. When he or she is on the right track, go all out and encourage him. If you quiet down, so will your dog, and he or she will lose interest in the challenge presented.
Good girl, good girl. Yes, yes, good girl.
Congratulations, now you know how to play the game. Place treats in random hollows and get your dog to figure out where the treat is hidden. Happy Tailz from us to you.